everybody, and welcome to the first episode of Let's Talk Art. This is me, Megha Kapoor.
And my name is Amit Kapoor.
To feed your creative soul with some creativity and lots of humor.
Yeah.
Today we have with us the president and the founder of the International Watercolor Society, GLOW, Mr. Atanu Dogan. So we welcome Mr. Dogan. Hello, Mr. Dogan.
Hello, India. How are you?
We are fine. Good to see you.
Good. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
So, how is the weather there? I mean, is everything good?
Yes. It is. Spring came a little bit late in Canada, but this is wonderful spring time we are having. Everything is great.
We are going to be a little casual here, and we are going to have a look inside your life story. So, we wanted to know, you were painting since your childhood days. I mean, how was your childhood?
Yes, actually I am hearing a lot of story about when I was a little boy, because we are a large family. Like, this is the youngest one. I am the youngest boy from the 8 kids.
Oh.
Mother and father, my family was with 10. So I am the youngest one, and I had 5 sisters. I have 5 sisters, and each of them is like my mother, you know, always they are taking care of me, and I am always looking forward to seeing them again. You know, when I was a little boy, always I was interested in drawing, paintings, or shaping some things. I remember like your boy, same kind of boy. He is.
Yes, true.
And especially, I remember those between maybe 5 and 7 or 8. I was interested in drawing on the wall, like all kinds, you know, clay or ceramic part or you know, some marker. Just I was painting my neighbor's walls.
Oh.
I was having some problem with my neighbors, and always they were complaining about I am messing up to their walls, and I was telling me, you know, don't draw over there, you know, just stop doing messing up the neighbor's wall.
Yeah.
But this is the one is I was remembering, and always. You know, I am missing those days, because with the kids we were having really fun drawing the neighbor's wall. Yes.
Right. So, okay. Also, we wanted to know about your wife, as she is also a painter. So, how did you meet, and how did this story begin?
That's really good. This is I met with her in university, in first year.
Okay.
But first were really good friends, good buddy, just having tea always in the tea garden, you know, we were chatting, laughing, doing things. 1 year just we were group of artists, always we were together sharing the foods and things. But second years things change, because I was in the paintings class in first years, but second year we start specializing one medium in art. Like I choose sculptures, and also she choose sculpture section.
And so second, from where you did your graduation, art graduation?
It's one of the nice fine art university also giving teaching degree, educational university for most of the art teachers graduating those school. It is in Izmir, third biggest city in Izmir, Buca.
Okay, 80. Okay.
Yes, 9 Eylül University, educational faculty in Buca. Our first homework or classwork, we were sculpting each other's bus.
Oh.
Okay.
And we were getting like a very close, just, you know, looking the face and things. and talking more, and you know, some emotional moment, you know, she was really emotional, and you know, like she was sad and trying some of the story, you know. And then also I was very soft, and that day I fell in love with her, and I couldn't sleep that night, you know. It started like after that I tried my dream sculptures, just making her.
Oh my God, that's good.
We become like a lover after that in second years in university, and we studied 4 years, and also we were really interesting students. Always teach our teachers and professors told us, you know, is every 10 years some students coming like productive like we are, because we were going always like some small village and place, taking photographs and going drawing sketches, bringing all those works to teachers. You know, most of the other friends, you know, they were having fun and party, that kind of stuff more. But
very hardworking student, huh?
Yes. And I'm glad we were working very hard that time. Still, we are using those photograph as a reference. Still, we are
great.
Like a live drawing skill and those, you know, on location paint. It, that time, we got really a good education. And since then, we're together with my wife. Always, we did all the shows, and we grow. We had 2 boys. Both of them is art related boy. One of them is a game designer, younger one, and he is in working right now in Facebook. And other one, you know, animation artist. Also, he is he study fine art high school, and he is really good with all kind of art. But he is really good with the animation. And
that's great. That's great.
Yes, now all our family, we have each of us rooms, and we are
studios.
some artwork in our line. Yes.
Great, great. So when did this idea of forming a society click to your mind, and what inspired you to make this?
Like we are artist family, you know, we always we earn and build this family with selling our artwork, you know. Always my dream was becoming international artist and knowing more culture, traveling all over, you know. That is the one of the my dream. And we work very hard when we immigrate to Canada, and full time we were just painting and selling artwork. And we were very successful in Vancouver, BC. We had 16 years, we had good income through the selling our original artwork in all kind of country, or traveling with the motorhome, sometimes in US, even sometimes some trip to Mexico and all across and Canada. We had a lot of outdoor shows, also gallery shows, also in art in the park shows. So we had enough those trips and hard working and producing, painting and selling. You know, always my dream was bringing also watercolor artists together, you know, meeting new watercolor artists and exchanging ideas. So after we are having around like 8 years in Canada, this is, I think, 27 years we are already in Canada. And that time, I went home in Turkey. And I built my own gallery, Dogon Art Gallery. Yeah, and we bought one shop just across from the waterfront. It was look nice. And we start making, you know, studio and bringing artists together and working all together. And then we built first our society, Izmir Watercolor Society.
Oh, okay.
Still working very well in Izmir.
Great.
And that second years in society, I organized International Watercolor Festival, first festival in 2004.
2004. My God.
Yeah. Oh. 2004 in Çeşme Peninsula is one of the summer vacation town, beautiful Aegean coast harbor town, and we made wonderful festivals. When I was in Canada organizing everything, and we went there and we met with artists and other my organizer friends who helped me, local people and municipality people, and we had wonderful celebration, watercolor festival over there. You know, since that time also it was really hard, because first experience, all my years just keep working, trying to communicate with people. Also not like these days, mostly manual letters I was sending.
Right.
So some of them I was reaching with the email.
Oh, yes.
And also my English not really good these days, but that time also worse, you know.
Yeah.
I try my best.
But you are speaking very good English.
I hope people understand.
Oh, yes.
So that time we had really nice festival, and all my colleagues, all other my students and other artists, they missed those days, and always they were telling me, you know, how good festival we did, why I am not organizing again, you know, because I have been in Canada meeting more international people and communicating with people. So, you know, one winter in Canada, 2013, like boring winters, you know, also I am a little bit off from the Toronto, is not much socializing place. Just I decided to help my society in Izmir to create online contest.
Okay.
And then I start that. It was Facebook was new tools, and I find out online contest on Facebook, it could work very good, because you are making like, and then people, you know, sharing all kind of tools, and it was very new tools, but it was very getting popular Facebook too. And we invite the artists, many of them, they open first Facebook page because they were interested in connecting the watercolor world, and it was a way for showing their talent on Facebook. It was, I think, first watercolor contest I start in 2013.
30.
And we find out some of the mayors also seeing, watching, because this is new tools also in world, like using the Facebook in 2013.
Yes, true. That time was the new
thing. Many people's excited, and politician is smart, you know, they say, I should use also this kind of platform. And they immediately, they offered me to have, you know, some events after these festivals. And we take those offer in one of the interesting town, Sajik, Seferisar, in the greater Izmir municipality.
Okay.
And mayor, you know, really art lover, smart and intelligent man. And after his support all the time to us, he gave the place for making the first our real society place. And he gave all kind of equipment, and we built the real society with in Turkey with the Turkish artists and our friend. And it's become our events under this real registered society, non-profit organization, International Watercolor Society, but just in Turkey. People all over the world, you know, attending or, you know, participating our events. In first event, it was really a crowd. And it was the first time that kind of events happening in world with watercolor. And that many different nations, artists, popular artists, famous artists in their country, they are coming and meeting in actual location. So since then, it's grow, And every year we start making events. And second year, more people came in same location. Our mayor had better support, and also some of our friends, business men, he was supporting his full, his effort, and his also like a personal effort too.
How many branches we have right now?
You know, actually we have more than 110 branches from all different part of the world. This is very interesting. First time in art history, some societies, art societies or art groups that much active all over the world, and you know, so united together and always developing.
Yeah, if I'm not wrong, this is the world's biggest art network.
That's right.
Right. Many, also, many artists, they joined this IWS society, and now we have a very big, you know, artist network.
Family.
Can you tell us something about the upcoming projects, the future projects, what you are thinking, that what you are going to, what the society is bringing up to the world? Can you tell us?
Actually, yeah, this is now, you know, we find out many years, this is almost 9 years more active with internationally, and many our leaders, you know, whom are start from the beginning, and these days, like many years, over 8 years, some 6 years, some 5 years, all different events they organized, and we know each other's more. We have now strong family. We are also very good friend each other's.
Yes,
and we trust each other's. And, you know, each leader's shipping like a bunch of paintings, if you are calculating how much it is, you know, many hundred thousand, you know, it's worth original, good quality artwork, no questions, giving, even no paperwork, nothing. Just hand to hand, we are making exhibition all over the world. This trust, these good friendships, bring more good people to around us.
It's looking and like now, a more, you know, family kind of thing.
Yeah.
That's true. Always we are calling IWS is our family.
Yes, true.
IWS is network. And these days we are making a more bigger family. We have more ideas because first we made the society non-profit. In the time, many other groups and business, galleries, museums, they like to join with us.
Okay.
And we let them to join us. And IWS Gallery, IWS Museum, IWS Art Village, IWS Cafe Galleries.
Oh.
So now it's growing, and we had some legal problem because this is non-profit society. Most of them register their home country.
Oh, yes.
And using the same logo, and non-profit society or charity societies, and other business also using same society logos and doing the business, personal business, you know, like those art village or art galleries or art materials, you know. So now we put a new design our society, which makes much comfortable grow, you know, institutions and non-profit societies and charities.
Okay.
We are calling mostly all business, you know, those museum, art galleries or art village, art groups like art studio, art centers, and we call IWS Art Network.
Network. Okay.
IWS Global Art Network, our official registers business name. And our register society names, International Watercolor Society. We have same logo but different title around. Image. This is the family, IWS family, and belong to this one, institutions, a business with this family. This is societies or charities belong to non-profit one. Now we are growing more, giving more chance for those individual or group business to join this family and growing all together, helping each other, supporting each other. Also, now we are giving chance to small business, like who has travel and paint or teaching studio, like teaching kids arts, and open for all those studio. Now, more and more studios and galleries and cafe galleries. It is interesting also subject, cafe galleries.
Yes, now, very interesting subject.
Few cafe galleries all different part of the world, especially London cafe art gallery is owner also our good friends and IWS members. Mm-hmm. He made the good contest just recently finished. You will see tomorrow those videos is coming up. How nice watercolor paintings came with coffee paint and also mixed coffee paint and colors. Oh. And this, so many good watercolor paintings from those poor country it came, because those country, oh, they are able to find good watercolor paint. We show them how to make good cafe colors, exactly working like watercolor. Just putting some honey or Arabic gum, just making with the Nescafe, it's worked very well. And you will see these few days, many videos and also those publications, all our last coffee business. So now we are trying to use all kind of opportunity to give all those people, all different part of the world, all different age, all different level, join our society. We are not elite society. We have some shows is very high standard, world high standard shows in some of the our organizers interested in some good museum, some good events. Also, we are giving room for any country, any, you know, lower circumstances, they are trying to produce art and they like to connect the rest of the world. Mm-hmm. So this is our strategy and it is going very well. And I am glad all artists, all our leaders in same mind, same excitement, we are growing all together.
So Mr. Dogan, earlier we saw that IWS was only promoting visual arts and watercolors. But now we can see that IWS has, recently announced music contest, and it's doing a lot of activities in other forms of art as well, and giving chances to, other students and other other fields of art. So can you elaborate a little about that?
Yes, actually, one of our dream was creating one of our society's song, like anthem.
Oh, okay.
Because whenever we are together in some events,
yes,
we sing together, especially when we are having side trip in the bus, just singing, some song, and, it is wonderful platform and nice atmosphere. And we thought we need those songs, and many years we were planning to have one. And these days, I think the right time we find, because everybody at home, all the musician at home.
Right.
And then we thought maybe this is good time to start a kind of contest, all those volunteer professional or amateur artists, they can join this music contest. Mm-hmm. And maybe we can find a really nice music for, explaining our philosophy and our excitement with a special song for IWS.
Mm-hmm.
It's going very well. And already we passed the poem lyric contest.
Yes, we saw that.
We choose around, from the many entry, we choose 16 poem also artists all over the world, some lyric writers, also good famous musician in the our contact team, like how we created this society with the good watercolor, famous watercolor. Now we are creating also music contest jury teams, same idea, making really good jury team. And then now also we find lots of good interest from the music world to connecting our watercolor network.
Great.
Let them to join the, our society, not society, our network, because our network is art network,
exactly,
and supporting always watercolor or with watercolor. These days we had slowed down for traveling, and we are able to see what we are doing, you know, because otherwise just keep going one place to other place.
Exactly.
Even we didn't know what giant organization we create, and you know, we didn't have enough time to enjoy what each of us create in our home countries and also internationally. But these few days, you know, I was joining the you know, my studio, enjoying and looking to all, you know, brochures and catalogs, you know, in some of them is other side, huge, like each country has like a nice large good prints, catalogs, all good quality art. Even we didn't have enough time to keep looking many times. You know, we can see we have some things for you know, enjoy and remember all good days, sharing the cultures and love all together in each different part of the world.
Right.
And our philosophy is, you know, just supporting peace and harmony through each of our identity, whatever we believe, whatever our language or tones, skin tones, or you know, our maybe language or believing, you know, doesn't matter. We are all same because we are artists.
Exactly.
And we love good things. We like beauty. We like to create the beauty. Creating beauty with the, you know, common language, with the color and brush and drawing. It is common language, doesn't matter. We don't have to speak very well same language, but we are understanding each other's very well. And artists and this organization is good sample for building up the new world with love and beauty and with multicultural connections and respect each other's.
So what message would you like to give to the youngsters?
Actually, our society very sensitive about the young generation, because we are building like a new art generation, you know, all our goal, making like a better societies and giving classes for the youngest, like making also some kind of contest, giving like some prizes and encouraging them to involve art more than like some, you know, nonsense things. And these days, many our leaders, especially to start in Hong Kong, kids contest and kids exhibition. And now is many our other branch start following those step, and like Ecuador and other country, there is many programs for young artists or potential artists. And we really likes to support the future, investing all those education and knowledge through those social media, like making our workshop demonstration and making nice digital library. And that kind of platform also gave chance to any art interest young people. They can reach us very easily because they are using you know, all the time social media, and we are in the social media and giving room to for young artists. I would like to take this opportunity to thanks to you, Mega, one of the great painters, good organizer, good wives, and especially good mom and good teachers and good watercolor leaders, organizer.
So I hope you must have enjoyed this wonderful journey of Mr. Dogan and have taken a lot of boost from this episode of ours. I hope that you will enjoy this. See you next time on Let's Talk Art.
Okay, take care and bye-bye.